Hey, this is Joseph with Appsmith, and in this video, we're going to connect Airtable to Appsmith using Airtable's new personal access tokens. Now, last year, Airtable introduced personal access tokens and announced that the old API keys would be deprecated. So now is the time to swap out those API keys and get a personal access token in your Appsmith data source. Okay, I have my Airtable base here that I want to connect to, and I have an empty Appsmith app with no data sources yet. So first, in Airtable, go to the Developer Hub. And then from here, you want to create a personal access token. So make sure you're on this section, not the API key. And I'll click Create New Token. Give it a name. And then we'll add read and write scopes. And I'm only going to select that one base that I want to work with. So this token will only be able to read that base. Now, once you get this token, make sure that you immediately save it into the data source in Appsmith or back it up somewhere safe. You will not be able to get this token again through Airtable, but if you need to regenerate it, you can, and then you'll have to update that in Appsmith as well. So I'm going to copy this token and head over to Appsmith, and then on the data section here, we'll add a new data source. Scroll down and find Airtable here. And we'll change this to personal access token and paste in the token. And I want to give this a name. Okay, so click save, and then you can add a new API. And first, I'm going to add a list records API. And then that asks for the base ID and the table name or ID. You can get both of those from the URL here. So first the ID for the base, and the second value there after the slash, that's the table ID. So enter those two values and click run, and you'll probably see it fail the first time. Airtable's API takes a minute to wake up for some reason the first time that you use it. It's a little slow at first, but then it works fine. So just make sure that you have the base ID from the first value in the URL and the table ID or name for the second one. Okay, so we have our records back. So now let's put it in a table widget. We'll go to the UI section here, add a new widget, and drag in a table widget, and then connect data. And you'll notice if you select the API, in this case, it doesn't automatically bind, because this API returns the data with a records array inside of an object. So rather than returning directly, it's nested one level down there. So we can go to data.records. And now we're looking at the actual row data. So at this level, you'll have an ID, a created time, and then a fields object. So it's taking all of those values and just showing it as a single object, and it's not really flattened out for a table yet. We're almost there. So the last piece is that we want to map over this data and show the ID along with those fields. So I'm going to map this for each record. I want to return an object. And when you try to return an object like this, it thinks those parentheses are for the bounds of a function. So rather than that, you can put a parentheses around it. It sees it as an object now, and I can return the ID as the r.id. Okay, we've got that field. Let's get back the created time now. And lastly, we want all of the fields. So to get that, we can just expand the fields, and we'll use the spread operator to show r.fields, and that just unfolds all of those values inside of the object. So we get the ID, the created at, and then just expand the rest of the fields, and now you can flatten the data and display it in a table.
All right, and that's how you can use Airtable's new personal access tokens to create an Appsmith data source and then connect to your base and display data in an Appsmith table widget. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.